Speak Indo Podcast is a medium to think about life while learning about the Indonesian language and culture. Hi, I'm Natasha, the host of Speak Indo Podcast. The first part of the story will be narrated in the Indonesian language. The second part will be in English. The transcript is available on our blog, speakindo.life, and our YouTube, Speak Indo channel. Season 2, Episode 4, Special Edition during COVID-19 Pandemic, Eid al-Fitr and Chinese New Year.
Sekali waktu, saya sholat Jumat di Masjid Al-Ittihad di Sungai Liat, Bangka. Masjid yang diresmikan tahun 2005 ini cukup besar, menampung hingga 500 jamaah. Umat Islam memang mayoritas di Bangka, sekitar 85%. Selebihnya menganut Kristen, Konghucu, Buddha, dan Katolik. Namun, kerukunan beragama di pulau ini sudah berjalan sejak abad ke-18 saat para pekerja dari Guangdong, Cina didatangkan oleh Belanda untuk menggarap tambang timah. Para pekerja ini kemudian menikahi perempuan-perempuan Melayu Bangka, melahirkan Cina keturunan yang masih banyak terlihat di Bangka hingga hari ini. Sebagian besar memeluk Islam dan sebagian lagi tetap beragama Konghucu. Kerukunan pun terjalin dengan harmonis di antara mereka. Masjid dan kelenteng bersanding di Bangka bukanlah pemandangan yang aneh. Misalnya, Masjid Jami di Muntok, Bangka Barat dibangun bersama oleh kaum Muslim dan etnis Cina. Bahkan warga Cina ini juga menyumbangkan bahan bangunan untuk membangun masjid tersebut. Di samping masjid telah berdiri lebih dari 80 tahun sebuah kelenteng Kong Fuk Miao, sebuah pemandangan yang sangat harmonis. Begitu juga saat Lebaran, warga Muslim mengantarkan ketupat Lebaran ke tetangganya yang Cina beragama Buddha atau Konghucu. Sebaliknya, saat Imlek, tetangga yang keturunan Cina mengantar kue keranjang atau yang biasa disebut tiampan ke tetangganya yang Muslim. Bahkan saat Lebaran, warga Cina keturunan ini datang ke rumah tetangganya yang Muslim untuk membantu memasak di dapur untuk menyambut Lebaran. Rasa menjunjung tinggi tenggang rasa dan kerukunan antar masyarakat juga diterapkan pada nilai-nilai kehidupan sehari-hari. Keakraban terjalin dari hal-hal kecil seperti saling mengunjungi ketika hari raya tiba. Walaupun isu rasisme dan konflik antaragama di Indonesia agak memanas, namun kerukunan dan saling menghormati antaragama di Bangka ini tetap terjaga hingga hari ini. Mudah-mudahan kerukunan beragama di Bangka ini bisa terlihat dan berkembang juga di daerah-daerah lain dan semakin marak. Selamat Hari Raya Idul Fitri.
The next one will be the English version of the story. Once, Irawan did his Friday prayers at the Al-Ittihad Mosque in Sungai Liat, Bangka. The mosque, which was inaugurated in 2005, is big enough to hold up to 500 worshippers. Muslims make up the majority in Bangka, about 85%. The rest are Christians, Confucianists, Buddhists, and Catholics. But the religious peace on the island has been going on since the 18th century, when migrant workers from Guangdong, China, were brought in by the Dutch to work in the lead mines. These workers then married Malay Bangka women, giving birth to the many Chinese descendant people who can still be found in Bangka till today. Most of them are Muslims, and some of them are still Confucianist. There has always been peace and harmony between the two faiths. A mosque and a temple standing side by side in Bangka is a normal sight. For example, the Jami Mosque in Muntok, West Bangka, was built together by the Muslims and the Chinese. The Chinese even also donated the building materials to build the mosque. Next to the mosque, the temple Kong Fuk Miao has stood for more than 80 years, a very harmonious sight indeed. During the Muslims' Eid al-Fitr holiday, the Muslims would deliver the diamond-shaped rice cakes to the Buddhist or Confucianist Chinese neighbors. Vice versa, during the Chinese New Year holiday, the Chinese descended people would deliver the basket-shaped Chinese New Year cake, usually called tiamban, to their Muslim neighbors. During the Eid al-Fitr holiday, the Chinese descended people would even help their Muslim neighbors cook in their kitchens to prepare for the holiday. Social tolerance and harmony among the people also apply in their everyday life values. Solidarity and closeness stem from small actions such as visiting each other during their respective religious holidays. Although racism and religious conflicts in Indonesia have been getting worse, the peace and religious tolerance in Bangka is still in place till today. Hopefully, the religious tolerance in Bangka can be seen, grow, and also flourish in other areas. Happy Eid! This is a story from Irawan Nugroho. He is originally from Semarang, Indonesia, grew up in Manokwari, Papua, studied in Solo, worked in Jakarta, then America in 1994. He currently lives in Fairfax, Virginia, as a freelance writer, interpreter, and journalist. This is one of our special editions as we face COVID-19 pandemic. We'd like to extend our deep condolences to those who have lost their loved ones. This is definitely a very difficult time for everyone, and we can only hope that soon we all heal as nature flourishes. Probably one day when we look back, we learn how valuable is the time that we have to hug our loved ones, to be kind to our fellow humans, and to thank the sun for shining upon us. I'm Natasha, your host of Speak Indo Podcast, and we would like to thank our guest speakers for sharing their story. If you like the story, please share it with your friends and family. The transcript of the story is available at our blog speakindo.life and our YouTube Speak Indo channel. You can subscribe to our channel so that you won't miss any upcoming episodes. Thank you for listening, and let's share positivity.